Hi everyone, this is Michael Buckley at KineFX, and today I'm going to show you how to set up a biharmonic capture network using the new KineFX ops. So let's dive in. I'm going to put down a fresh geometry node, dive inside, then I'm going to put down a box, set the mode to polygonal mesh so we can get some resolution on this guy, scale it up a bit, increase axis divisions. Okay, that looks good. Then I'm going to put down a skeleton node, come over, display that, template the box, come to the orthographic state. Then I'm going to hit enter to enter the skeleton node state. Make sure I'm in the create mode. Then come in and just drag up some joints. Okay, cool. So now what you want to do to set up the biharmonic capturing is put down a bone capture lines. So you want to plug your skeleton into that. Okay, the next thing you want to do is put down a node that will create a tetrahedralization of your skin geometry. There's two ways to do that. One is with the tet embed, which you can plug your skin mesh directly into, and then the bone capture lines at the right hand side display that. And that will give you a reasonably good approximation of your input geometry in a tetrahedralized form. So that's one way to do it. The problem I have with this method is that it will do an adaptive tessellation of your mesh to create the tets. So as you can see over to this edges here, it has to create more tets because it really is trying to capture those hard edges. So that sometimes is fine. But more tetrahedrons will cause the binding process to take a little bit longer. Another thing you can do is put down a remesh node and do that tessellation yourself, essentially. So triangulate the mesh yourself and then use a tet conform. Plug the remesh into the left-hand side, bones into the right-hand side. And then the tet conform will take that triangulation and create the tets from that. So basically the scale of your triangles that you give it becomes the scale of your tets. You can see this cooked a lot faster than the other one, and we still have the outline of the shape to a pretty good approximation because the remesh does a great job of capturing those hard edges on its own. So once you have a tetrahedralization, you can plug that into the bone capture biharmonic node, the right-hand side, and then your skin, get rid of this guy, goes into the left-hand side. Okay, and if we come up to the geometry spreadsheet, we can make sure that we do indeed have capture weights on the skin geometry now. And then we can just plug in a bone deform. Plug the output of the bone capture biharmonic into the left-hand side. Take the rest pose for your skeleton and plug that into the middle input. And then we can just make sure things don't blow up. We can plug the potentially animated or deformed stream into the right-hand side. We can just hook that directly up to the original skeleton. That looks good. Now let's put down a rig pose and actually apply some deformation to that right-hand input and view the result, and we can see that it is indeed capturing correctly, which is great. Cool. And because it's we went this route and we're using the minimal amount of tets, in fact, we could even go coarser if we wanted to probably and still get a decent result out of this. That means that we can come back up to the skeletons and sob now and actually add joints to it if we want. If we decide we need maybe an extra bend in this, we can just create those joints and it will just recapture immediately, which is really, really nice. It's one of the great things about KineFX and everything just being procedural is that the rebinding will just happen automatically. Cool. So that is how to set up a biharmonic capture network from scratch in Houdini. Thanks for watching. Bye.